Hey, what's happening, everybody? I'm Tommy C, and I do a show called In the Crease with Tommy C. We're going to be talking about Sidney Crosby's Mumps, the Toronto Maple Leafs with their upswing, the Calgary Flames with their downswing, and we got Chicago Dead on Dave here to talk about the one and only Chicago Blackhawks. Stick around. This is In the Crease with Tommy C. Morning, guys. Monday. Let's do this. What's happening, everybody? It's In the Crease, Tommy C, and I'm here with none other than the great Chicago Dead on Dave. We're going to be talking about Sidney Crosby and the Mumps. What do you think of that?
The Mumps. I got the Mumps.
My Mumps. My Mumps.
My Mumps. My Mumps.
My lovely Mumps. Crosby Mumps. I hated that song when it came out.
Yeah, well, I can't believe we just got a Black Eyed Peas fucking reference from you. That's incredible.
Actually, somebody sent, I totally can't take credit for that because somebody sent Harrison Moody and said, please do one of your parody songs, which he's really, really good at. And I highly recommend that he makes My Mumps, what have you. You know, speaking of, isn't it just like, I don't know, like, is this just like we were talking about before? And of course, you know, me and Dave aren't doctors. Is there something going on here? Is this just like some kind of weird strain? I mean, certainly all these guys could not have been inoculated. Is this something to be concerned about? I mean, it's obvious that nobody really knows what the hell's going on. And look, you know, Sid's going to survive the mumps. I mean, he's a professional athlete. It's not the end of the world. But is there something going on? I mean, is this just a freak and we'll just remember the year of the mumps? I don't know.
I think it's really weird. I think that's the biggest thing of it is the NHL has no idea, and they have doctors, and you would assume good doctors.
I would imagine.
To look into this type of stuff. The weirdest part for me is when everybody who played in the Olympics, who went to Sochi, got inoculated for a numerous amount of viruses. They're going into fucking Russia, you know. Sure, you never know what you're going to get in Russia. And one of those, it's documented, was the mumps. They got their booster shots for the mumps. So either this is some weird kind of strain, or they drank mumps juice. I don't know. Like, it's just a fucking weird thing. Sometimes this happens.
You know, I read
there's a strange mutation. I
read on Yahoo Sports, and yes, and you know, like I was saying to you offline as well. Like, you know, we live in the Western world, and we have this idea that like nothing bad, that never a disease can't come through, and certain things are gone, and certainly that could be the case. Now, I've made references or jokes about Jenny McCarthy and lack of inoculation, but I got to be honest with you. I have no idea if that's the case or not. Maybe it is. Maybe it isn't. I'm sure they'll find out one day, and then I can bitch about it. But it's just only Yahoo Sports reported that only 500 people in the entire North America actually got the mumps. I mean, that's why it's so bizarre. I mean, this is a freak. If look, 500 people got the mumps last year, okay? And we already know upwards of 10 have got it in the National Hockey League. In a small, I mean, it's just unbelievably bizarre. And it's already like, I mean, I'm sure those 500 people didn't even know each other in most cases. Yeah. So now we have guys in a small. So, I mean, I really just don't know. I don't know what to think of the whole thing. Part of it.
There has been little things like this. I mean, staff was a thing a few years ago in the NFL. Yeah. In the NBA. I mean, they've had staff and other things. Mumps isn't the same, but I don't know. It's just maybe there's a trainer or a doctor that has connections with all these guys that nobody has picked up on yet. There's got to be a common thread between the 10 people, and that's what I'd like to know.
Yeah.
What's the common thread? Because that's the first thing my mind goes to.
Absolutely.
Other than hockey, of course.
Yeah, right. I just think there is. It's just weird. I mean, obviously they're giving to each other on the ice. I mean, I would think. Yeah. I mean, there's body contact, there's sweat, and you know, if anybody's ever played hockey, I mean, hockey equipment is the smelliest, disgusting shit. Especially when you put it in a bag if you've been done sweating in it. I mean, I can imagine all sorts of wonderful bacteria just get, you know, trapped in there, and you know, even with switching jerseys and stuff. But I mean, you know, both me and you have been in the military, and I make constant military references, and I don't care if people don't like it or not. But I mean, I know what it's like to live in like close quarters, in have showers and like group showers and what have you like that. I mean, diseases get passed. I remember one of the drill sergeants told me that getting sick is a part of basic training and how you fight through it. So I mean, to have look when you play athletics, when you are in these
call them locker room
situations. Lots of shower together and what have you. And I'm not trying to be like weird or about it or anything. It's there are a certain amount of disease to get past. But I mean, this, even with this, this is really uncommon. And I don't know, Dave, I'm getting a little concerned.
I don't know. This on piggybacking on the Ebola craziness.
Yeah.
Maybe there is a little something to be concerned about, possibly. But we don't play hockey very often with these players, so we're probably not going to get the mumps. So that's a good thing.
It'd be great if the fans got the mumps. Great if Ryan Lampert and Greg Wyshynski got the mumps.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be great if it wasn't the NHL players? It was just all the reporters we can't stand.
It would be hard to tell the difference between them having mumps and just the liberal cocks in their fucking mouths. So it would be
no kidding.
It would be hard to tell the difference.
That's the mumps.
But before we get any farther, I have to do something. This is a surprise. I'm calling you a little bit of an audible.
Mm-hmm.
Something special happened.
What happened?
It's an amazing event. Congratulations to one Tommy C. And why?
Why?
He got his first victory in fantasy hockey this year.
You're just glad.
Probable victory.
You're just glad it wasn't you.
I'm so glad that first.
Yeah, everybody was just kind of wondering like who's gonna be clipped. It's just so bizarre that I mean this is like almost a year to the week that I actually lost a game last year, and it's just ridiculous. And then Cronin, who signs up for this stuff every year and he doesn't actually play,
could have
probably knocked off.
He
could have knocked off. Had he set his team probably even once or twice, he would have beat Troy, who's also
he would have beat me if he would have set his team.
Yeah, well, he beat me and he didn't set his
team.
He
did beat you. But you're 1-8,
yeah,
and you're trending upwards, so that's a good thing. You're coming off of a victory.
Yeah,
I think things are looking up for Cook's text messages.
Cook's
so
text
messages.
That's the team.
Yeah,
and
good.
Maybe I should get in touch with Wazzle. You know, maybe we should just like break some stuff down. And, you know, like
yeah.
Like,
well, if you want, I can give you advice. I'm doing pretty well.
Yeah.
I can help you.
Also draft second. You know, that helps. Yeah. Who do you got? Like, you got like Stamkos or something?
I look at who's trending and I just make some good moves. I'm just brilliant. I can't help
it. Yeah, but what's like your key guy? Stamkos?
I haven't even had to ride Stamkos. That's the funny thing.
That's bizarre.
Kessler has done really well for me.
Yeah.
Well, and I don't have any Blackhawks, which pains me.
Who cares?
But, I do have.
Now would be the time to get him.
I'd cross.
I have Duncan Keith.
He's not had a good year.
He's not having a good year. And that was like I thought that was a really good draft. I thought Duncan Keith would have been a really good draft. You know, he's a guy I really respect. But I wonder if because of Letty leaving and maybe they changed their game a little. Obviously they made some changes. I wouldn't say they were struggling at the beginning of the season, but they were not.
They weren't the same team.
They weren't performing to Chicago Blackhawks standards of recent years, and I think that's kind of fair to say. They
made a minor trade too.
Yeah. 718, we don't have a jam-packed show for you. 718-395-7660, 718-395-7660, or you can hit us up on Skype. We have put you on. The Leafs.
Did you hit the Blackhawks trade? Did you hit that one? The little trade they made?
Yeah, I did. And from what I understand, this guy actually I could put Kazar on with the two shot. From what I understand, why can't I put Kazar up? There he is.
There
From what I understand, I forgot. The guy wanted out. Jeremy Morin,
yeah.
Yeah, Moron. What was his problem?
He's a young kid. He's not getting the playing time that he was hoping he was going to get. He was a healthy scratch for like 8 games in a row. He was on a conditioning assignment mission down in the AHL.
Yeah.
And he hasn't been tearing it up there. So they trade him for another 23-year-old, but a defenseman. Tim Erickson, and he looks like a better fit for us.
It is kind of interesting, it's of course losing the prospect Hayes to the New York Rangers.
Yeah.
It is interesting that maybe like we're going to get some a decade from now some perspective, like maybe how many good players fell through the cracks of the Chicago system just because
just
they were
so
ridiculously good.
Deep they are. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, it is kind of thing. Matthew Kazar, what's happening, buddy?
Nothing much, you?
I can't hear you.
Nothing much. How about you?
Same old crap.
Yeah.
Getting threats from feminists online.
Staying up late, doing wrestling shows.
I did a wrestling show last night that I probably had no business doing, even though it sucked. Did you watch that crap last night, that pay-per-view last night?
The wrestling?
Yeah. You watched that crap?
No, I didn't. I watched the Edmonton Rangers game.
Ah, yeah. See, that's a true hockey man right there. Look at that.
Actually, I did, because I wanted to be on Cronin, I did skip. I actually did skip the Ranger game for a change. Mm-hmm. Well, you know what?
Probably the most boring game. You didn't miss anything.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say, report. Give us a report on the Rangers. What do you think? Because I really trust your opinions and your views a lot. What do you think of the New York Rangers? Where do you think they're going to be at the end of the season? What do you think their goals are? I think that's an interesting topic.
Well, as it is now, I think they're in the 10th position, mm-hmm. which for me is pretty surprising.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me too.
During the game, they showed this chart, like all of the players they acquired during the summer mm-hmm. and all of the players that left. Mm-hmm. And I don't think it shows right off.
Yeah.
But you guys losing Strahlman, that's a huge loss.
Absolutely. I mean,
he's a really, really steady defenseman. And even a guy like Brendan Boyle, who is like really good on faceoffs.
And they lost a trio of players, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah. They did lose their heart, and what, they all ended up in Tampa Bay. What about Pouliot, you know, as well? I mean, I thought that was, you know, sort of the Pouliot Zuccarello line last year was really a lot of the reasons they made the Stanley Cup final. I feel like they are missing that.
Sure, and I don't think here's the thing. The Canadians are kind of in the same situation. They lost Gianta and Georges. A big part of their leadership core.
Sure.
But the thing is, when you have Lundqvist behind you, mm-hmm. anything can happen. He's, in my opinion, mm-hmm. maybe top three goalies in the league.
Better than Carey?
Lundqvist. Carey, too, actually.
I definitely have Lundqvist in my top five. There's no question about that. Yeah. I mean, the Rangers are playing a lot better as of late, too. I don't know if anyone's noticing this or not. They're 7-3 in their last 10. They've won three in a row.
Yeah, it is a little surprising, but they did sort of have a bumpy. I mean, they had a bumpy November last mm-hmm. year. They had a bumpy October, and I don't know if it's not important for me that they're the top of their division, although it'd be absolutely nice. But it does kind of lower expectations when you go to the playoffs, and believe it or not, that actually helps. Yeah. I see even with the moves, I still see the Rangers as a very talented team. I think they're honestly better than the Bruins.
I think that's fair.
Yeah, I think they're honestly better than the Bruins. But, you know, Mr. Gazar brings up a good point. They lose the core of their, you know, look, a lot of the run for the Stanley Cup final was based on emotion.
Yeah.
Dealing with tragedies, getting behind Martin St. Louis, who's playing great. Nash is stepping it up. But when you lose those guys that react to that emotion, that react to that, it is really concerning going into the playoffs.
Sure.
The good thing is that the East isn't that deep as far as teams. I mean, honestly,
that's your best friend right now is the fact that it's not a deep division.
I don't even think the Penguins are all that good, and especially now Crosby. I mean, he's not having his. I mean, he's having a good season, but it looks like he's not going to win any kind of scoring title this year. Certainly the Mumps don't.
He's out of the top three.
He's out of the top three. I mean, that's not, you know, which
still
is
still pretty friggin' early.
Well, who said not to grab Crosby first in fantasy? That's what I said.
I wouldn't have grabbed him first either.
Yeah, everybody else did. They always grabbed him first.
But the good news is that there's a huge difference between regular season play and playoff hockey. And
very true.
Different players step up. Like, you won't see a Pacioretty or a Rick Nash perform during the playoffs. They're more of a regular season type of player.
Yeah, obviously.
The playoffs is more for players like Dominic Moore, who had an excellent playoff. And
it's about those catalysts. I agree.
I like to see the regular season as kind of a skills competition.
Mm-hmm.
But the playoffs, that's the endurance
test. You still got to get to the playoffs. I mean, that's the thing. You still got to get there. And let's keep Crosby in perspective for a second. He's 3 points out of the lead. I mean,
but he's going to miss a week or two.
It's not like Crosby's in this big slump.
Yeah, but it's not like he's got. It's not like that one year that Mary Lemieux got cancer and then he came back and he still won the scoring title. He's only 3 points and he's going to miss like a week or two. Yeah.
But the thing is, Crosby's at his best during the regular season.
Mm-hmm.
So if his regular season isn't that hot, I'm not anxious for his playoffs.
Yeah. He's got a ring. He's one. He's there.
Look,
he's,
I know what he's down his talent, but I mean, let's face it, Dave. They've found laughable ways to be eliminated the last 3-4 years since they won the cup. I mean, it's
very,
it's
very
almost,
true.
It's
I'm not gonna try to argue that point because they have.
Why,
but it's hockey. It's a different season in the postseason. We know this.
Yeah. Well, what were you gonna say, Matt?
Why is he considered the best player in the world when Jonathan Toews won more Stanley Cups than him?
You're French. It's Toews.
It's Toews.
God, I can't say names. I don't know what's wrong with me.
Isn't that a French name?
I don't know. That's why we pronounce it. Doesn't sound French.
Doesn't sound French.
Why don't we call him Toews and not Toews and not Toews? Somebody call me in and tell me why we call Toews not Toews and Toews not Toews.
Oh, well, actually, his mom is French and she wants it to be pronounced the French way.
I want it to be fought the French way.
Crosby is the best player in the world. That's why he's. It's just how it is. We can say that he's not, but everything else points to the fact.
Crosby's the best player.
I don't think so.
He's the most skilled player in hockey in the world right now.
It doesn't show that skill.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Well, let me say this. If he's the most skilled player in the world, mm-hmm. how come during the Olympics we had to put so many wingers next to him and nothing was clicking? By the way, during that Olympics, he had one goal. One goal in the last game, and it didn't eat shit.
Because he has a short – because in a two-week span in the Olympics, because he didn't perform at the greatest level, does not mean he's not the most talented player in the fucking world over
the – Yeah, I got to agree with Dave. Matt, I got to agree with Dave. I think you're talking – see, I think you guys are sort of arguing about two different things. We're talking about the Sydney best player. We're talking about the best player, what they bring to their team, almost like an MVP. I don't think there's any doubt, Matt, that he's the most skilled player in the world. The guy can simply do it.
I agree with you there.
He brings to the team is a different story.
Yeah, and I think you guys agree with each other, and you don't even know it, sort of. I don't think anybody's really questioning his skill. It's just what he brings. And, you know, there's other – as talented as he is, there's other players in the National Hockey League that I think people who – don't worship superstar status, find more attractive. Jonathan Toews' leadership, his you know, I mean, he could put it in the net too, and he could make plays happen. Let's talk about Ryan Getzlaf over in Anaheim. He brings aspects of the game that are sort of, like he has parts of his game that I would like out of Crosby. There's a lot of other players out there that bring stuff to the table that Crosby doesn't that makes them – you know, maybe arguably better than Crosby. I would have said early on that Alex Ovechkin, like in 2004, 5, 6, 7, you know, I thought he was clearly the better player.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And there was a time where Crosby kind of caught up and he won his Stanley Cup, but I said he was a player. But then there was also a time where I thought Malkin was the best player in the league.
Sure.
Malkin sort of lives in Crosby's shadow. I mean, he's tougher and meaner and can do more and faster. Mm-hmm. Crosby's talented, there's no doubt about it.
Yeah.
But there is something that I find like I would take over the talent. All right, what he brings to the table, as good as it is, I would take my chances with other groups of players. And Jonathan Toews would be top of that list.
Sure.
Ryan gets left. You can make the argument for Steve Stamkos. Ovechkin, if his head wasn't squarely up his ass. I think that's what we're talking about. I mean, you guys agree with me, or where am I?
See, here's the thing. Something I like to do when I'm talking about greatness of a player and trying to put him in perspective is I take him off the team and see where the team is without him. I don't replace him with the player because that's a completely different exercise. I take him off the team completely. Mm-hmm. If you take Sidney Crosby off the Penguins, where are the Penguins?
Well,
over the last 10 years.
I agree,
But if Malkin picks up his game like he did after, you know, when Crosby got hurt in that Winter Classic a few years back, I mean, you know, Malkin put the team in his back, and I do think that Malkin's the type of player. Where would they be? I think still first place. Stanley Cup?
I mean, you're talking about a guy who has 26 assists, who's a catalyst for his team at times in the regular season. He doesn't always do it in crunch time. I agree.
Yeah.
But when him and Malkin are on the ice, it's quite a friggin' sight to see.
Yeah.
He seems to be – he has great vision. He seems to slow the game down a little bit for everyone around him. And that's what you want out of a player. Do I like Sidney Crosby as a human being? No, he's a fucking pussy, and he whines and cries, and he's a baby. Do I have the utmost respect for him as an athlete, as a player, and as a hockey guy?
But what Kassar is saying – sorry to interrupt. He's saying – but is he the best? Is he the best you can bring?
I get what he's saying, and I think the answer is yes.
The truth is, down the road, it's the playoffs that count, and I agree.
But he's won. He's got a ring.
He does have a ring. I mean, Matt, I mean, that's
he's won. That's it. He's not Dan Marino. He's won.
A player, like, if you're calling him the best player in the world, don't you think he should have more than one ring?
Not necessarily, because you look at the
talent. I mean, Toes, he has more Stanley Cups.
Yeah,
Jordy,
but you
I will say this. I will say this.
They're not the best players in the world.
I agree with Matt 100% on this in the Crosby debate. That team, not even just Crosby, that team should have made deeper runs in the playoffs. And they shouldn't have.
And if they weren't playing it in an era where you have the type of talent that we've seen, the Blackhawks, the Kings, that are being considered as dynasties, you might be right. Look at the fucking Bruins a couple years ago. They looked like they were fucking unbeatable. Then you have to contend with teams like the Hawks and the Kings over a four-year period are just dominating. Yeah. That's not all on the Penguins.
But
and
that's
not, and certainly not all on Crosby.
True.
I don't know.
Yeah.
You know what? I don't agree with that because of some of the things, penalties, the key penalties he took, lack of productions in big spots. You don't see that problem with Jonathan Toews. Let me give you a perfect example. I think it was the year they won the Stanley Cup, and I was it in the second or third round. I think it was against Detroit. Toews lost it, and he had to have a veteran player, and I can't remember his name.
Seabrook.
Came over to him and said, "Johnny, you got to calm down, and you got to bring it down." And a lot of guys, especially guys, young guys like Jonathan Toews, who wear the C, that may have been just too much for their ego to handle. I'm the captain. Yeah, you're a vet, but I'm the captain. He didn't. He reacted to that. And I thought, like, you know, he was kind of acting like a little bit of a baby, taking bad penalties, doing what Crosby does almost yearly. You can set your watch to it with Crosby. But Toews was able to do a self-inspection and saying, you know what? Seabrook wouldn't have came over to me if he didn't give a crap, and he's probably right. And I need to get my shit together to lead this team.
But doesn't that have something to do with how you're brought up through the league as well and expectation? Who has done that for Crosby? Crosby's had his dick sucked by the entire world
and
been told that he's Gretzky since he was 12.
Yeah, I think
and Toews hasn't. Toews has had to work really fucking hard to get where he's at. I'm not saying Crosby hasn't, but I'm saying they've had different paths. Plus, that Hawks team, for the past 5 years, they've had the best depth. Mm-hmm. In the NHL, arguably, you can't. I mean, it's incredible
you can't
how
say
deep
that,
they go.
You know, I mean, the Pittsburghs are no slouches either. They're great.
You look at the supporting cast of the Hawks.
The Pittsburgh Penguins on paper are a frightening hockey team. You look at that. I mean, it's like, holy crap. They're a frightening hockey team as far as their offensive power.
It's a tough debate. I mean,
it really
it's a
is.
Good
the,
debate.
The biggest difference I see between Crosby and Toews is that they're some of the best players in the world. It's for sure they're going to take some abuse. But whereas Crosby, after he takes some abuse, he's going to try to stick them back and even try to fight them sometimes. Toews, he'd kind of walk away and ignore it. Because during the playoffs against the Bruins, I've never seen a player take so much heat as Jonathan Toews with Zdeno Chara.
Yeah.
I mean, Chara was on top of his back and he just walked away every single shift. Yeah. And Crosby, he goes nuts, and against the Rangers, there's the Lundqvist sprayed him with a water bottle.
Yeah,
which is pretty funny.
That was the whole theme of last year. It was the water bottle playoff.
Yeah,
you know, it was like a lot of things. Everybody's getting into the water bottle act.
I'm gonna
close the show on this, and I think one thing, like, look, Toews was Jesus Christ.
Oh,
now you got me
doing
it. For Christ's sake. Jonathan Toews was
a
high was a tie was
it's
was,
it's Kassar.
Kassar.
No, it's not
Kassar,
now.
No, Kassar. I think I'm saying it correctly in Turkish, by the way. Not you.
In your neighborhood, that makes sense.
Yeah, Kassar. It would be because it was Kassar. You know? I think. I don't know. There's a lot of people named like Oblique, and the Turkish names are really bizarre. Kassar.
Kassar.
But no, I'm going to leave it in this. You know, you mentioned before, you know, Jonathan Toews was still a highly touted draft pick. I mean, he was expected to come in the league. And yeah, it wasn't like Crosby. But I really wonder, and I think this just has to do with the human condition and not necessarily Sidney Crosby or Jonathan Toews. You know, when you're put on a pedestal like these guys are, and all of them were to some extent. Yeah, maybe not as high as Crosby, but all of them was. I really think it's individual character that reacts to that in one of a couple different ways. And I think Crosby has reacted to that, like so many, in a negative way. There's a lot of talk about nowadays where kids have, like, oh, God, I mean, look at this YouTube show where I can sit there and pretend I'm a freaking celebrity. And, you know, we have these things where we take pictures of our food, or every time we take a shit, you know, it's on Facebook, like everybody cares. It does sort of create sort of a, I think there's some truth in this, sort of a narcissistic a way of looking at yourself, thinking the world revolves around you. And but I do believe, I mean, I do these things. I'm very much involved in social media, and I think I'm still a reasonably humble person. But I think that has to do with probably my DNA makeup.
Yeah.
And I think some people do not react to that negatively, and I think some people react to that positively. And young kids don't act. I mean, he was put on a pedestal. He didn't react to it positively, but something in Jonathan Tate's DNA, or maybe some kind of upbringing, his family, I don't know, of simple values and principles that maybe Crosby's family didn't have. I don't know that for a fact.
Maybe you perform better when you know you have to work your way up rather than already being at the top.
And I think it's priority.
I'm kind of disappointed to see that Connor McDavid, they're saying the same thing as Crosby. Maybe we'll see the same thing as with Crosby.
I wonder with Dave McDavid. I think that fight that he had a few weeks ago says a lot about his character and who he is. So hopefully that'll be a little bit different. Let's end the show. Stick around, Matt Cassar. You can stay with us. And let's talk about last night in the National Hockey League. Last night's games in the National Hockey League. The New York Rangers go over the Edmonton Oilers in an absolute snoozer! They go over the Oilers 2-0. What is that? They lost 25 in a row now, the Edmonton Oilers. Shockingly, I got to be honest with you, the Los Angeles Kings are a little bit of a downswing. They go down to the Toronto Maple Leafs in the shootout. Leafs make it 5 in a row. Pretty damn good. Calgary goes up against Chicago. Chicago takes them down 2-1. I did not catch that game. Was Calgary putting up a fight, or was this just typical Chicago domination?
You know what? It was typical Chicago domination. It wasn't as close as 2-1.
Let me tell really? You so the score was a little bit. But that makes it 5 in a row for Calgary. They lost 5 in a row with a really good
Hawks
start.
Hawks are 9-1 in their last 10.
Yeah. Well, we'll see. They'll turn it around. They got Johnny Hockey from New Jersey over there. A lot of great legendary players in the great state of New Jersey. Tonight in the National Hockey League, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, the Ottawa Senators go up against the Connor McDavid sweepstakes, which I think they're losing. The New Jersey Devils will probably get crushed by the New York Islanders. The real deal on the island coming to Brooklyn. Islanders take on Jersey, 7 o'clock. And also at 7 o'clock, which should be probably the best and most interesting matchup of the night. I'll definitely be sure to catch this game, whether I hear about it or not. The Tampa Bay Lightning take on the Pittsburgh Penguins. Crosby is Mumpy. Mumpy! The Mumpy Penguins! They're not there. All right. Thank you very much for tuning in to In the Crease with Tommy C. Thank you very much to Matthew Cassar, caller extraordinaire. Thanks for being on the show. Of course, thanks to my co-host and good friend, Dead on Dave. If you want to catch tomorrow, it'll be at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. That's In the Crease with Tommy C. A little morning ice for ya, radio guy. And please check out Shot from the Point, Shot from the Point Live, which was absolutely amazing this week. Sunday's episode of Shot from the Point Live. Go in the playlist at the top of the channel to check that out. It was really good. And make sure you check out my interview. Did you check out that out, Matthew Cassar? The interview I got from Dead on Dave?
I saw the thumbnail. I'll check it later this week.
Oh, click. Yeah, click,
no
like,
fucking
subscribe,
plans to watch
share,
that
come
bullshit.
On.
I will. I'll tell my friends.
Like and share. Show you care. We'll see you next time, everybody. This has been In the Crease. Tommy C. A Shot from the Point production. See? I'm a narcissist. I start talking like I'm on TV. Jack, all the things were done.